So our topic for the day is how to start a private practice in 2021. Again, this is a really unique time for us to be starting a private practice. Anybody that is interested in starting one, because you are not going to have to get an office if you don't want one. I do think that there's going to be a need, and there is a need for in-office therapists now, but that is really dependent on your personal values, where you're at, you know, location-wise, if you're ready to go back to the office. You know, there's a lot of different things about that. So I haven't been advising anybody like, yes, you must go back to the office or else. You can decide, but there are also a lot of opportunities for online therapists right now. So you get to decide whether you want to do an in-person, an online, or some kind of hybrid. What I've been seeing a lot of people doing lately is they started integrating back into their office maybe 2 days a week, and then they're in you know, online 2 days a week. So that's an option for you. You want to make sure that if you do a virtual practice that you still are following like all applicable laws, that you're registering your business appropriately, that you're following whatever your state laws are, your boards, making sure that where your license is, where you're doing therapy, and just all of these different things. Again, another unique thing that has happened is a lot of states have opened up like emergency licenses for people. So it's really great. You have the opportunity to, you know, maybe practice in a state that is not where you reside, but you can get a temporary license. The next thing that you want to really think about is your marketing strategies. Again, this is going to look a little bit different depending on what kind of practice that you're building. You want to make sure on your website or whatever marketing strategies that you have that it clearly outlines what kind of therapy that you're doing, whether you're using telehealth, virtual. I don't recommend using the word telehealth. A lot of people don't know, you know, necessarily what that means. I think by now, maybe more people have gotten an idea of what telehealth is. But before, people didn't really know what that was. And the term was like, what's telehealth? But, you know, online or video, or, you know, use some kind of wording that the layperson will understand and make sure that's clear. I do recommend that if you are doing online counseling, that you have a service page for just that. We've had that for a long time. So it's really helpful in terms of people understanding that this is something that we have done and that we will continue to do. I'm going to take a moment to thank our sponsor, Therapy Notes. If you're looking for an electronic health record that's really full service, one that can help you run your in-person, virtual, or hybrid practice, I want you to check out Therapy Notes. You can do your sessions straight from their platform. You can bill from there. You can send the client paperwork. It is so easy to use them and really run your practice efficiently. So be sure to check out Therapy Notes. The same thing goes when you're running a virtual practice or you're just starting a practice, is that you want to make sure that all of your business strategies are set, that you have a business plan, that you have, you know, some kind of accounting records, that you have some tracking methods, that you have some ways that you're going to see how your practice is doing, if you're hitting your goals. You want to make sure that you have talked to a lawyer, that you've talked to an accountant. So this is your year to really think about what serves you in private practice, how you can start a practice that is really meaningful to you. I am a big advocate of people starting private practices this year because I think that the need is really going to be there. People are still going to be calling. I was looking at jobs yesterday with a registered intern that I'm working with. We were just kind of like scrolling to see what was out there, and I couldn't believe how many private practices were hiring. I have never seen that many private practice hiring. And it just really, you know, stood out to me is that people who really have good marketing messages, good business systems, they need people because the calls are coming in. So if you are ready to either maybe join a group practice or you're ready to start your own, this is your year. I'm here most days answering your questions. I'll see you soon, everybody. Bye.